Hello and welcome to Weaste Allotments. Today we bought us aliens for the year. We bought 50 of these golden granite shallots. Actually, you don't get 50, you get 20. I'm going to buy another 20 of these. Now the sowing period is any time from September, which is now, up until December, and you're looking at a crop around about June for these, and yeah, they're very nice. The next lot on the list are these snowball onions. Now I've got 50 here. They're a white onion, Japanese onion, very harder, and they're decent size, but they don't half taste gorgeous. Well, they taste great with cheese and crackers, and that's what I use them basically for. And I might buy another pack of these, so I've got 100. I did buy 150 of these. Again, they're another Japanese onion. They're a brown onion, as brown gold, brown red, white. That's normal colours. Now these again, and with the white onions, you put them in between September and December, and you're looking at a crop of around about June. So you know. And I do always do well with these, so these will be going in one of my beds. And what we're going to be doing after that, we're going to be getting the garlic, and we'll be doing not so many this year, do about 300-400. Yeah, we go through a lot of garlic, but again, I think I've got about 20 garlic that I saved from the 400-500 or so that I grew this year. I saved the best ones, so we'll be splitting them. I'll show you how I split them, and yeah, we'll get on with that probably in about 2 weeks' time. So what I'm going to do now, we're going to patch this in with a walk around that we did earlier today, and then I'm going to talk about the website, and you know what's going on there. So further ado, guys, let's get on with the walk around. Well, welcome to Weaste Allotments. Today we're just going to go on a bit of a tour. I just noticed there on the strawberries, a couple of leaves are starting to die back now, so it will be come a point in time where I take all the leaves off these and tidy the beds up for winter. You're going to have to excuse the wind, guys, it is pretty windy today. I'm just looking at this pennyroyal here, what's drooping over the side of this raised bed. The bloody sorrel is it's doing all right, it's holding its own. The basil looks really good as well, really nice. Forget what this one is now, I think it's marjoram, if I'm not mistaken. It's absolutely lovely. This one here, I've actually got a label here somewhere, is the thyme. And at the moment, the bergamot is drowning out the golden origami. Some lovely flowers on this bergamot. And then we come round here, and again, being drowned out just down there is the chamomile. Like I say, the flowers are starting to all die back now. The hanging baskets are nearly finished, so I'll be emptying them and getting ready for the big W. But we've got a long time to go just yet. So look at in here. This is the front greenhouse. Now these, I've got still got tomatoes in here. In the other greenhouse, because there was about 4 weeks in front of these, they've all ripened and I've picked them. As you can see there, there's some of them plum tomatoes, and like I say, you've got your cherry tomatoes here, and Elsie Craig, and you've got your money makers, In amongst them you've got a load of chilies ripening. There's another little chili plant there which is doing absolutely fantastic. As you can see, they're all ripening on their own, these tomatoes. Be taking another big basket of tomatoes home tonight. And they all come out of here. That lemongrass is doing alright. Again, another strawberry bed's doing fine. I've got this, there's not much in here. There's a few plants and what have you, and a few peppers. I'm keeping that shut. This mint needs trimming, and I'm going to give the, I did say I was going to give the mint to my mate's daughter, because she loves minty. Peppermint this. And as you can see here, this has gone crazy. It's escaped the pumpkin. It's climbed over the compost bin, and now it's 10 foot down the allotment, and it's throwing out more and more pumpkins as we go along. But there's two fantastic pumpkins on this. We come in here, I mean, look at that, that's an absolute belter. And there's several more inside here. But if we come round here, you might be able to see another one, another big one. yeah, lavender and thyme and sage and mint and I forget what the others are, but yeah, they're doing wonderfully. Like I say, I've let them go really too tall. The mint's gone crazy, and I was warned it was going to do that, so it's my own fault. But it's coming out of there next year. We'll put something else in its place. Moving on down here, let's have a look in here. There's another one, another big pumpkin. And apparently there's some squashes in here. I've yet to see them. This one now is escaping over the side, which is a butternut squash. And that one's escaping over the side, which is another butternut squash. So yeah, we've got a fair few there. Here's my neighbour's pumpkin patch. He's got the dreaded blight. And well, he's took a load out, but he's left them in. He should have took the tops off them. Now, when he did it, when I noticed this here, I immediately went down to the bottom of my plot and took all my tops off my potatoes. So when we get down there, I'll show you in a minute. Fruit bushes, I should say, are starting to lose the leaves now. The dahlias are still pumping out beautiful flowers. And another lovely cactus dahlia there. These pom-pom dahlias, I love these. This is a white one, obviously. We have got yellow ones and orange ones down there. And we've got more cactus dahlias here. Here's another beautiful dahlia. The colours in that, absolutely fantastic. See, the arch is still there, that's good. Dahlias here, another sort of cactus dahlia. We've got quite a lot of dahlias here. Oh, look at that, eh? A poppy, it survived the wind. There's a few more poppies still to come on the scene here. But what I will be doing is taking all these poppy pods and collecting all the seeds for next year. And I'll be doing that very soon, because they're starting to self-seed themselves in the ground. But this is a spot where they always grow them. And another spot over in the middle there. Fruit trees, well, they're full of fruit. I don't know if you can see over there. There's some lovely apples there, and there's some cracking bramleys and dessert apples and what have you. Moving along down here, past the water tank. As you're going to see now, shock, shock, horror. All the tomatoes have all gone now. Now I need to clean the glass here. Now I've been doing an experiment, and I'm going to pull all these, and these are going to be thrown. Now the experiment was clover or the verve compost. Now I'll let you know more about that in another clip. There's a beautiful, I forget what it's called now, flower that Alan Jackson brought down, and again, another beautiful one there. These are just a few tomatoes. Just going to leave there, and I'm going to take the seeds for next year. A few onions there. These peppers are doing really well. Oh, there's a spider there. But the peppers are almost ready. There's more peppers over there, and chilies here. And these Scotch bonnets are looking beautiful. Joe Long. There's some Joe Super Long in here as well. There's about 8 or 9 different varieties of chilies in there, maybe 10. Grapevine's lost all its grapes, it'll soon be losing its leaves, and that's when I start to take cuttings for next year. I don't know, well, you've probably seen Alan Jackson's video there. I give him one of my grapevines there. Well, I've got more grapevines there, and I say I'm going to try and keep them going, and everybody who comes down to the allotments, I hope to give one and send them back as presents. So yeah, I just noticed something's been chewing on one of my peppers there, and it's not looking good with that pepper, but I'll be taking that off anyhow. But yeah, greenhouse, chilies, peppers, looking really good. I'm just drying these out. This is for the roof. I'm going to be sorting these out very shortly. There's the one side of the roof's done. The other side's not too bad. In fact, I could leave it, but I won't. I'm going to do it. Might as well do it all. The black kale's doing really well. The beetroot's doing absolutely fantastic. There's my girls there, up to no good. I'm just going to see if we can pull a couple of these out of here and see what we've got. Let's have a go. They're a bit big. Let's see what else we've got here. They're all getting excited now. They think they're getting something to eat. Well, they're not too good. Hang on, let's get in here. Yeah, they're about right size then. All right. We'll have a few of them in a bit. All right, girls, you get it in a bit. Don't worry. Look at them all getting excited. I don't know. It's a Brugger shallots. I got 4 eventually. Out of 40, I ended up with 4. Somebody ended up with 30 of them. Don't know. But they took 2 rows of them, and the ones what was left was underneath the beetroot here, and they missed them. So I got 4. Bit naughty really. As you can see here, these are the parsnips, and there's lots and lots of carrots in there, and we're not going to touch that until around about the end of October. And the reasons why we ain't going to touch it, because I don't want to disturb the carrots, just in case the carrot fly hits. These are all going at tip. These are all the potato leaves. I never leave the leaves. I never put the leaves in the compost. I always take them home. Inside them buckets there, guys, are spuds. Absolute lashings of spuds. And I count 4, 12. There's about 15, 16 buckets there to do. This compost is going in this bed. So what I'm going to do, these I've been giving the leaves to the girls, these collies. We've not got anything decent on them, so now I'm just using them to feed the chickens, and the chickens like them. These are coming up next. These are the next thing on the hit list to come up, the leeks, and they're done all right. I don't like them too big, to be quite honest with you. They taste nice around about this big here, about an inch and a half. I've been taking some cabbage, but there's had a problem with some of the cabbage there. I had to take them up. I say I've got a club root in this bed and that bed. I'm going to be hammering this bed this year with lime and what have you. The corn, I've been taking the corn, but it's doing no harm where it is at the moment, to be quite honest with you. But all that will be coming out next week, all the corn, so this bed's going to be empty. And all what will be left in here will be the celery, and maybe one or two of these cabbage. This bed here, I'm going to give it a good raking and cleaning.
And in there will be, the onions are going in there again. I've been putting the lime and all sorts of stuff in there. And then in this bed here, the garlic will be going in here. And again, probably garlic in this bed here. So I'll be doing garlic again in these beds this year. I clearly haven't sorted this club root out, and anything like fleshy, like beetroot and stuff like that, don't do too bad in this soil what's got the club root. So that's what I'm going to be doing. And I'm going to be growing stuff what is not really affected by it. And like I said, these other beds will be taken over for the brassicas next year. There's the potential shed. We shall be getting cracking with that very shortly. I've got the letter in my shed. I've not even seen the chairman for about a week now. I don't know where. I think he's on holiday. So as soon as he comes back, I'll be giving him the letter and we'll be getting stuck in. So there we go, guys. That's the plot in its September glory. Like I say, these bags won't be in, then buckets will all be put away very shortly. And I'm going to... Also, what I'm waiting for now is some wood chip to do these paths. We ain't got no decent wood chip yet. But as you can see, there's no weeds in any of the paths. I've not touched these paths in weeks, months. So, you know, pretty clear, so I don't really need to do it, but you know, it makes it look nice when you've got a new layer of wood chip, and that wood chip will be the next base to walk on. Now this is rotting down. We could dig this out and chuck it on the beds, it's that well rotted down, but no, we're going to keep it as it is, and we use this as the base, more wood chip on top. And well, we get the decent wood chip around about October, so that's what I'm waiting for now, guys. The decent stuff to come. There's the flag there. I actually took a picture of the flag, and in the sky there was two contour trails where the planes had crossed each other, and it's like a big X, and it's like this is where the treasure's buried, sort of thing. If I can be bothered, I might show you the picture. It's quite funny. I thought it was funny anyhow. And that happened earlier today. But yeah, all the apples are doing really well. I've been taking a few baking apples. These apples here, they're about another 2 weeks ready for taking. And they are a really nice crunchy dessert apple. The baking apples are lovely. This is had a right hammering from the aphids, the red aphids this year, and next year we'll be right on top of it, I tell you. So there we go. There's the update. Looking really well. Keep you posted, and there's something I need to tell you. So we're going to go over there, and we'll tell you all about what's been happening today. I'll be right back, guys.
So there you go, there's the tour in all its glory. Everything's looking reasonably well. Like I say, it's coming to the end of the year now. So a lot of stuff's going to be coming up. The corn's going to be coming up next. And the rest of the beetroot. Maybe one or two of the cabbages will be coming up. Now I'm going to be starting putting the onions and the garlic in shortly. So that's something... look forward to. I'll show you how I plant them, how far apart and what have you. And yeah, so like I say, I've had the builders in since yesterday, and it's been absolutely hectic at home. It's not the sort of thing you want to do when you're setting up a competition up, and you just launched your new website. It's been absolutely nightmare. And then I goes and find out that the website that I've picked is very similar to another one, so I've had to rebrand it to Allotment Diggers, which is there, guys. And it's up there in the top right hand corner. As you're looking at the screen, you can actually click onto it and go and check it out. Also, guys, I've been adding a few things to the actual page. If you look in the left, in the right-hand corner, you're going to see a little chicken icon. If you click on that, you subscribe to me, if you want to subscribe. If you don't, click on the other corner. There's nothing in the other corner. So there we go, guys. So I've had to rebrand the actual site, change everything around. It's been absolute nightmare, so I've not been able to get back to everybody and reply to all the messages now I normally do. I am getting there, trust me. Quick message to Terry King. The easiest way to subscribe, mate, is if you go onto the site, which is in the top right-hand corner, you can actually subscribe through Google Plus. Now, the Facebook is being populated. You've got to ask permission for it on Facebook to actually put your actual link on. So we're waiting for confirmation before. So you can't do it that way, but you can do it on Twitter or on like the Google Plus account, or you can just fill it in normally and just follow the step-by-step instructions there to get on the site. There's a few lads that have popped on. I've actually put some of your videos up there as well onto the site, Terry, like you asked. And same with Muddy Boots. I've been putting a few up there of yours as well, mate. So if anyone wants to watch these videos, there's a whole host of different videos up there. It's not just mine. There's quite a lot of other people's there what's asked me to put their videos up. So I say, if you go on, guys, and you'll go on these other channels and you see them, like, these guys are really, really dedicated, and like I say, fan base is what it's all about on suppose on YouTube. So why not give them a go? Go and subscribe to them. Every one of them, absolutely fantastic. Them two that I've just mentioned there, Muddy Boots and Terry King. You'll learn a lot from them. They're newcomers. Well, I won't say newcomers. They're not that new. They've been going for a while, but they do a lot of DIY stuff. What you need to you know, pick up on the allotments. And it's not just the allotments. They're pretty handy at the cooking as well. A bit like my buddy Alan Jackson there. I like that the way he did that egg curry. Or is it, egg, I think it was an egg curry, or chilled egg, get it right. I actually smacking my chops when I was watching that video. Absolutely awesome, fantastic video that. And like I say, guys, if you want to pop on the site, in the top right hand corner, that's where you can do it. And if you want to subscribe to us on this channel, just click the chicken in the I think it's in the left or the right hand corner. You should see a little round little chicken icon, and you can actually subscribe that way, subscribe to the channel that way. Like I say, at the moment we've got everything up in the air there. We've got the builders in. I might even throw a few pictures up of that. Early in the week, the flag was flying, and in the sky there was this contra trails where two planes are crossed each other, and it's like an X in the middle of in the sky. And I actually caught it on the video camera, so it's so funny. Like, you know, the X marks the spot, the pirate treasure. So I might throw that up as well.
Hi guys, if you look where the flag is there, and you just look to the right of it, what can you see in the sky? A big X, pirate flag, and X marks the spot. Can't make you.
Like I said, I've been very busy, so I've not been able to do very much. But in the next 3 or 4 days, we'll be putting a lot together. And plus, we've got the end of the competition coming up for them scales. And who knows, there may even be another one yet, another competition. Like I said, I've got lots and lots of things there. I've got brand new, never used, I've never even opened them actually, and they're all gardening stuff, so we'll throw a few more things up for grabs there as well over the up and coming months. But as for now, this is it for this week. If I can get a video up on Sunday, I will do. What makes it even more, actually, makes it more frustrating, I actually got a phone call there from one of my buddies there saying the match is this Sunday, fishing match on Upper Bimbo, this fishery. It's a very good fishery. And he actually said, yeah, of course, count me up for this one, guys. It's absolutely fantastic fishery. This was before that hit the fan. So I've got that as well. Yeah, it's going to be an epic week. But we're putting it all together. And in the next update as well, we're going to show you a few clips of the wine. And I did say we was going to do a review on some compost. I've done the review, but I just haven't got the time to do that at the moment. That was going to be a separate one. So anyhow, thanks for watching, guys. I'm sorry about the sun making me, messing. I think there's all sorts of pictures here. Shadows cascading over my face. I don't know. But for now, like I say, I just got to get everything sorted out. Not enough time in the day to do it all. But thanks for watching. I'll see you all very soon. So from Weaste Allotments, a good evening to you.